Welcome to Record Types, a video in the Who Sees What series on data visibility and access in Salesforce. You often need the ability to organize and gather data in different ways and at different times around the same object. For example, you may have one case object, but two variations, internal and external. They might gather slightly different information and need different picklist choices. Even the business processes that each flavor goes through may be different. Record types are the answer. They're an incredibly versatile tool that helps you manage and organize data about an object. Record types control three things: business processes, page layouts, and picklist values. Business processes are special picklist fields that capture the life cycle of opportunities, cases, solutions, or leads. Page layouts let you select and organize groups of fields related to an object. Picklist values are the lists of choices that you define when you create a picklist field. You can define a master list with all possible choices and use record types to display a subset, depending on the situation. Let's take a look at this in the app. We'll create the business processes, page layouts, and record types we'll need for internal and external cases. Then we'll create and assign our picklist values. First, let's add any values we need to the status field. The status field is used by case support processes. We'll type in any new field values we need for either internal or external cases and click Save. Then we'll go into the support processes to define the processes that are unique for each type of case. We'll create a process for internal. Now we'll create a process for external. Next, page layouts. We'll create the internal layout first. Before you do this, make sure you've created any custom fields you'll need. The custom fields we'll use in this example have already been created for us. We've got a custom field for location, so we know if the employee logging the case is in headquarters or in a satellite office. We'll drag that onto the layout along with employee ID. For internal cases, instead of the contact field, we're going to use a custom lookup field that looks up to the user table. Let's remove fields that aren't necessary for internal cases, like account. We can't remove contact field, but we can move it to a new section, so it's out of the way. Notice that there is no field for record type yet. As soon as we create at least one record type, the system will generate a field called Case Record Type, and we can then add it to the page layouts. This isn't necessary, but your users may find it useful to see which record type they're using, especially if they have access to more than one type. We'll save the internal layout, and now let's create the external layout. We'll base this on the existing case layout, and we would add any necessary custom fields, delete fields we aren't using, and organize everything into sections, and save. Now we'll create two record types. We'll name this record type internal. Choose the internal support process we just defined, give it a description, and make sure that it's active. Now we'll make this record type available to the profiles that will use it. Only our support users create internal cases, so we'll select just that profile. On this screen, we'll choose which page layout to use. We'll select the internal page layout we just created and click Save and New. Now we'll create the external record type. Both our sales users and our support users create cases for customers, so we'll check both these profiles and click Save. Next, we'll create all the picklist values we need. We'll go back to the Field section and add some values to the Type field. We can assign these values to the appropriate record type and click Save. The last thing we'll do is add the record type field onto both the internal and external page layouts, so any user that has access to more than one record type can quickly see which type they're using. We'll go back to Page Layout and edit both the internal and external layouts. Done! Let's log in as a support user to see what this looks like from the perspective of our end users. We're logged in as Lars Ross. When Lars creates a new case, he can switch between the record types if necessary. The description field for each record type displays here, making it easy for him to know which type he should use. And choosing a record type provides Lars with the fields, picklist values, and business processes that he will need for that type of case. He won't be overwhelmed with choices he doesn't need or fields that don't apply. Things to watch out for. Once you've created and assigned record types, you can edit those assignments by profile in the Manage Users, Profiles section of the setup pages. If any records have already been created in your system before you have created and started using record types, those original records will not have an associated record type. You'll need to retroactively assign the proper record type ID. You can use Data Loader to extract your cases. Be sure to include at least one of each record type so you have the ID. Then you can apply the correct record type ID and update the records using the Data Loader Update button. For more information, see the following topics in Salesforce Help or visit the Salesforce Success Community at success.salesforce.com. Thanks for using Salesforce.